Hi, I'm Rosalind Schanzer, and I'm the author and illustrator of George versus George, the American Revolution as seen from both sides. Today I'm going to read you the introduction to this book to tell you why I wrote it, because it's about King George III and George Washington. And so I'm going to read you the introduction in the first two pages. Introduction. There were once two enemies who were both named George. George Washington was the man who freed the American colonies from the British, and George III was the British king who lost them. Was King George a royal brute? American patriots said so. But others hailed him as the father of his people. Was George Washington a traitor? The king's supporters thought so. But many celebrated Washington as the father of his country. Who was right? There are two sides to every story. And then the first chapter is entitled At First Glance. The year was 1763, and in many ways, George Washington of America and King George III of Great Britain were very much alike. Both men had light blue eyes and reddish-brown hair. Athletic and dignified in appearance, each stood well over 6 feet tall, towering above most other men during a time when the average height was 5'7". Both were honest and popular with the public. They liked simple food and much preferred plain clothes to the high-fashion outfits of the period, decorated with lace, ruffles, and embroidery. George III was sometimes called Farmer George because of his lifelong interest in agriculture. George Washington was a farmer who was happiest when working on his land. Both were excellent horsemen and loved hunting. George III believed that a king should rule America. For a long time, George Washington thought so too. He had even fought bravely alongside the British Army. And then I'm going to read one more page. So stop for a minute while I find it. Okay. In my books, and this is one of them, I often use talk balloons, and inside the talk balloons are quotes from real people who lived during that period. And since the book was written about both sides of the story, I'd like to present an interesting comparison between two of the quotes, and I'll show you the picture just so that you can see the balloons of the two people who are talking. The guy over here is Patrick Henry, the famous Patrick Henry. He was a colonial statesman and orator, and this guy on the right is Samuel Johnson, who was the greatest English writer of his time. And here's what they had to say. Patrick Henry says, Patrick Henry, by the way, believed, and everybody believed, that we were slaves to the British. He says, our chains are forged. Their clanking may be heard on the plains of Boston. I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death. Samuel Johnson replies, how is it that we hear the loudest yelps for liberty from the drivers of Negroes? That's what you can do when you present a story from both sides.